Hey guys, thank you so much for purchasing one of our take-home kits during this isolation. Today I'm going to run through a video and show you how to make the apothecary unit. So without further ado, I have everything prepped here like you should have received in your kit at home, and I'm going to go ahead and start sanding everything. If you have an orbital sander and a space to use it at home, go ahead, use your orbital sander. If you don't, you're going to have to take your sandpaper that I provided with you, and you're going to go ahead and sand it going with the grain, okay? And you're not trying to oversand this or anything. All you're trying to do is just clean this up a little bit, open up the pores of the wood so that when you put the wash on or the stain on, it's gonna actually penetrate the wood and not just sit on top, all right? So without further ado, I'm gonna take a sander and I'm gonna get. Guys, so once you're done sanding, you want to really make sure that you clean all the dust off of your workspace. When it comes to this specific project, because there's so many cubbies, I do like to stain and paint everything before assembly. It is hard to kind of get into some of these grooves once it's all put together. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to apply some stain. Over here, I have some of the Van Gogh paint in balsamic. Head. Take some balsamic from the Van Gogh chalk paint line. Okay, again, I'm just going to put... Well, you know what? I'm probably gonna need a little bit more for this project, just because it is a bigger piece. I'm gonna fill this up with water, and I'm just gonna give it. Just take my paintbrush that I just cleaned last time, because it's a little stiff. And I'm gonna go ahead. And I'm gonna go ahead and just get this on, okay? Okay guys, so I've gone ahead, I've tried to stain and dry everything up as best as I can. I do want to do a two-tone distressed, you'll see. So basically just watch what I'm doing. I'm going to use this beeswax puck right here to go ahead and put on any of the areas that I'm going to be applying paint so that when I go to distress it, it's going to create that resist between the stain and the paint. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to take these guys. And if you come closer, I just want you to see that I want these to be at the bottom, if that makes sense. You'll kind of see what I'm saying in a minute. But, like for instance, you see how this is kind of on the bottom of this line? So if I put this one this way, this is gonna be on the top and it's not gonna be the same. So these all have to go the same way. Fit, I promise. And same with this guy. So we want to make sure that that's going down the bottom way as well. And when you paint them, they do tend to swell a bit, guys. That's what happens, obviously. It's a water-based product. And the wood goes ahead and absorbs that moisture. Sometimes it makes it swell, and then it can get a little bit tricky. I'll just take my rubber mallet. And just so you get an idea, it's basically gonna be like this, right? And then these little guys are gonna go here. There's gonna be one at the bottom as well. So that's gonna go at the top there. And then you're gonna have your side pieces. So it's gonna kind of be like this. And then we're gonna have our top piece, our top piece. That's gonna go inside. So these are gonna kind of go on it. And this piece is a little bit shorter. It goes on the bottom, okay? That way this piece goes nice and flush. So that's how it gets put together once everything is done. So anything that you see on the surface right now, because again, I want these cubbies to stay brown, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna take the wax and I'm gonna rub. So I'm gonna rub this here with the wax puck. And I'm gonna rub the outside. First things first, I guess I'll do these guys. You just want to stay on the top of these, okay? Just wherever you have applied the wax. You can even use the Van Gogh wax. You don't need to use like a bees puck. You can use the Van Gogh wax. You can use like the hemp oil from Miss Mustard Seed milk paint line. So there's a few different things you can use as a resist in between two layers. On the areas that were on top. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my sander, piece of sandpaper, or also you can take a sanding block for this. Sometimes the sander can be a little bit aggressive for this, but I'm gonna take my sander anyways, and I'm just gonna very lightly. So now we're going to go ahead and we are going to start assembly. So in some of my videos you'll see that I do like to In some videos, you'll see that I do like to tack things sometimes with the nail gun before I do screws. And I'm gonna do this right now because there's a lot of pieces going on and you don't need to be fumbling with them. So I'm just gonna take my nail gun and anywhere that it is meeting up, I'm gonna go around and I'm gonna tack it. Okay, and just tack it somewhere that you're not gonna have to put the screws. That way it's not in your way. Okay, tack here, and then just one. Okay, attach the back, because right now the back is not attached. So I'm just gonna bring this down and I'm gonna tack in the back. That means I'm just going low. Okay, same thing here. If I pull this all the way up here, then it really gives me the freedom, right? And I'm just gonna tack. There's an inch and a quarter brad nails in here. Okay, and you can do it along the sides too, guys. Like to take a little bit of wood glue and just run a bead along, because these are not going to get screwed in. These are going to be tacked and tacked alone. This guy here. Make sure it's nice and flush to the bottom. So now what we want to do, guys, is we want to just pre-drill, honestly, only here, and here and here. That's kind of where we really want to have the additional support to hold this frame together. So I'm just going to spin this bad boy, okay, and force a bit here, switch that out, get my canvas in, okay, and I'm going to go ahead, one at the top, and one closer to the bottom. Top, one closer to the bottom, same on this side, top, just pull this again, I like to have my working space, and this is up high, right, like there's a little bit of a lip under here, so you have to make sure that you're going up in this area, and then we're just going to take, inch and a quarter screw size. You don't need anything really large to be doing this. And we're just gonna snug those in, okay? And then you can just take some wood filler if you want, or you can take a small paintbrush with a little bit of the paint mascara and just fill in those little holes. Okay, and I'm gonna go and do it on. Take a small little paintbrush with the mascara and just get a little bit of paint on the lid here because I don't need a whole bunch. Okay, and then I'm gonna just fill in these holes. Just from looking at this, I think I want to paint the bottom piece here. I think it'll look better. So I'm just gonna get a little bit of paint. I like to carry it over. And I'm just gonna paint this. And just paint this here as well. I just think that that looks a little bit neater. Okay. Let that dry. Once it's all dry, I'm gonna go ahead, sand everywhere that I need to sand. I'm gonna take my wax, okay? And when it comes to the wax, you just wanna make sure you wipe off your surface. You're gonna take your wax. You guys have gotten a sample size of the wax. And if you come over here, you'll see. So before, just wanna get rid of some of that paint from the holes. Before, and then once you put on the wax, look at that. After. So the point is that you want to put the wax on, but then you also want to rub the wax off.
Okay. And then you end up having this beautifully smooth, professional finished piece. Once you're done waxing everything, you're gonna take the library tags that you received in your kit. And honestly, this is probably gonna be the trickiest part of the entire part, is you're gonna put these library tags on. You're gonna have to put them on, if I can just open one of these little kits. Okay. Put these guys here, okay? So you're gonna take them, the little screws are in there too. Sometimes I take a little nail. I just take maybe like a permanent marker, I place them and then make my spots, and then I take a little nail and I just kind of pre-bang them because they are little screws. And I take a little screwdriver and I just go ahead and I have to kind of get those all in, all 12 of them by hand. And then if you want, you can take some paper, soak it in tea, take some craft paper, crinkle it up, and you can cut them to fit these little library tags to size. Take an old stamp or something and stamp them up and make it look super old, antique style apothecary event. So, thank you for joining us for this video. This is the apothecary unit kit. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to me, and I should be able to help you with any of your questions or concerns. And I hope that this video helped you. And please share any of your videos of your finished kits. I always like to see everybody's finished products when they're done. Stay safe and happy building.